Hello, YouTube, it's Steve. So here we have is the SD Cross Silhouette, Sisquiede, the normal, and the Titans version. So with these, honestly, I think they're pretty damn cool. You know, I built them, and I actually hated them. I thought they looked just grotesque. Monsters. What kind of madman would put a mono eye on a Gundam? But you know what? I come to love them, and I nurture them, and just treat them as my own. So regardless, even though I do have some issues with the whole mono eye, I guess it overall adds to the personality and the aesthetics of the suit. But regardless, let's go ahead and get into the review. And don't forget, you can get these kits over at newtypehq.com. Use that promo code KrowSama, so that way you can get 10% off your kits. But if you want to get anything else, they do have a pretty massive selection over there. But hey, let's move on to the review. So we're taking a look at the SD form first. We're essentially going to look at the SD form of the Titans. And I think it looks okay in this form, but with the Cross Silhouette series, you're really going to want to have that frame. I think that's where the series just really shines, but regardless, I'll show you a little bit about what the SD form is going to look like. First of all, the construction is pretty damn good. The way you're looking at this suit now is a complete out-of-the-box build, but without the stickers. So, yes, it looks somewhat plain, but just from how it looks right now with the bare plastic, I honestly think it looks pretty damn good. So whenever you are painting this, honestly, minimum paint is going to be needed for those extra little details. And here's the sticker sheet. So essentially what most of these are going to go to is like the green for the top camera. You have like the yellow that's going to be on the chest and some other little parts. It's for basically the waist and the chest as well. And posability is going to be out of the window when it comes to the SD form. Obviously your knees and elbows, those are not going to have any articulation whatsoever. But the hands can basically move around, the shoulders can move a little bit. The legs, they can spread open a little bit. The waist is hardly going to be able to twist because it's very constricted with the waist and the side skirting. But yeah, it's just really limited. So for the mono eye, it's actually going to be this clear pink piece. Looks really good, to be honest. Me personally, if I was the one to paint this, I would keep that to the side and then reuse it after I painted the kit. Honestly, there's no need to paint this little piece right here. And the thrusters on the back are actually on ball joints, so if you want to maneuver them in any kind of like particular position, you're really going to be able to achieve that with the ball joints. Now looking at the eye field launcher, it is a pretty nice cannon. It does have a long range beam rifle, also a powerful mega cannon. But since it is an eye field generator, it's going to be able to pretty much block itself or, you know, defend itself pretty accurately from beam projectiles, which is it's always a good thing. And of course, the Sisquiede is going to have the beam sabers. The unique thing about this is I believe this is the first time that the Cross Silhouette actually had separate beams from the beam saber hilts. Very unique. I've never seen that on the previous kits, and I hope they do continue this kind of like trend in the upcoming Cross Silhouette line. And here we have the normal version of the Sisquiede, but this one is actually going to have the Cross Silhouette frame attached. So yeah, proportions look much better, it has better articulation, and I don't know, it's definitely a step up. And for range of movement, here is the elbow, basically going to get a good 90 degree bend. And the arm can go up about that far. Leg spread is actually pretty minimum, and the knee is only going to be able to bend about 75 degrees. And you are going to be able to get a pretty damn good ankle pivot. And of course, both kits are going to have the same exact accessories, so the beam sabers and the eye field launcher. But yeah, other than that, it's just a different color version. Now when it comes to the cruise mode, I honestly don't like it. It looks really pointless. But yeah, if it's your cup of tea, if you like these kind of transformations, then hey, more power to you. But for me, it kind of just serves no point to, you know, for anything. Well, for my final thoughts, honestly, these are two amazing kits. You don't need to get both of them. I just got it because, you know, I'm collecting every single Cross Silhouette kit. But for you, if you just want one, you can easily get away with one, especially if you're painting. So if you just get, you know, the normal color, you can go ahead and just paint it to the Titans color and vice versa. But regardless, they're going to come with the same things. Just the Titans version has two white stickers that are extra. And that's pretty much it, guys. So, really great kits. Definitely needs the cross silhouette frame to just kind of complete it. Comes with great accessories. Finally, the beams are separate from the hilts. All around, beautiful. Mono eyes are fantastic as well. So, but that's it for me, guys. Definitely thank you for watching. And like always, rate, comment, subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll be seeing y'all in the next video. Bye-bye.